Welcome to the Hog Zone. All right, y'all. We have some random stuff coming up for you today. I'm going to show y'all how to make hog's head cheese using everything, the hair and the bone included. So stay tuned right here on the Hog Zone. Nah, but really, y'all, if you guys haven't checked out the Hog Zone yet, you need to check it out, man. There's some real random stuff on there. Funny as hell. Some great stuff, y'all. Check them out. All right, y'all. What I am going to do today is I'm going to boil up my son's hog skull. And he got quite some good tusks on it and everything, so I'm going to show y'all how to take and make your own European mount. First, we need a hog skull, preferably a pretty decent one. My son's first boar, y'all. And as you can see, it's got some pretty nice cutters on it. Doesn't really matter where you start, y'all. It's a mess all the way around. I usually leave the snout because it helps to pull some of that cartilage out. You get a lot of bone right near the surface. Razor knife, to me, is about the best thing to try to use. Try not to cut too deep so you don't get into the bone. Everybody pretty much knows how to skin. You're just gonna skin the skull. One place as good as another to start. You get the point, y'all. Skin her out. You should take as much of the flesh off as you can get, folks. You see, first time out with the pot here, bone's already being exposed. So cut a little bit of this flesh away, get it cooled down. Dogs will have some nice snacks. The more you can get off, the faster this will go. Tongue. Put it back in the water for a little bit. This is why I leave the nose on, y'all, for last. You can just grab that nose and just pull all that right on out of there. And at this point, I'm going to put a turkey piece down in there. Easier to pull it out. All right, don't lose your cutters, folks. Because look, I've already lost one tooth over here. They'll pull right out. Okay, watch this. How long of a cutter do you want? It's huge. It's quite the cutter, y'all. Alright, y'all. Now give me a shish kebab stick. For lack of anything better to use, you just basically scramble it up in there. Then I use the garden hose to spray in there and try to get it rinsed out, cleaned out as best I can. Not pleasant, but it's gotta get out of there. Rinse it all out, put it back in the boil. I'll take it in the house and scrub it up in the sink and then set it out to dry. Just residue on it now. Alright, y'all, cleaned up. Now I just have to let the skull dry out and then I'll be hitting it with peroxide later on. Damn nice cutters on Caleb's hog.